myself to now apprehend it.
My Lord.
But this one thing I do.
All right.
Forgetting those things that are behind.
Mm-hmm.
And reaching forward unto those things which are before.
My Lord. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I press forward.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Toward.
Yes.
The mark of pride of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus.
Yes, sir.
And you already have it.
I know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Look.
My Lord.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to say a few words concerning our faith.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Every minister knows, every lay member knows, if you've been affiliated with the Bible,
amen,
in any way,
mm-hmm,
a colorful character the Apostle Paul was,
mm-hmm,
and is.
All
and
right.
That's right.
Many times I call him the saint, one of the saints of patriarchs.
Mm-hmm.
Because he is one of the, out of all that we've read,
my Lord,
has such an uncommon and yet true devoted love,
yes,
for the church and Christ Jesus.
Uh-huh.
That before he was conversion of the earth,
mm-hmm,
he was such, let me put it in my own words today.
Well, I'm preaching.
And I want you people to feel confident.
All right, mm-hmm, speak on.
He was such a horrifying character.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Before he was converted.
Uh-huh. All right.
Uh-huh. One of the master's work.
Yes, sir.
He was a miracle of a man.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
He was mean.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. My Lord.
He was cruel.
Well.
He was hateful.
Mm-hmm. What you said.
And yet despiteful.
Mm-hmm. My Lord.
Toward God's people. In fact, he was a plain hostile.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. He just couldn't tolerate,
my Lord,
God's people.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Anything anybody proclaimed or professed of, according to the true God,
mm-hmm,
that we now worship.
Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And you know the turning point, you know the turning point in his life.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Riding down a road, somebody hear me today.
Mm-hmm. Yes. All right.
It's called the road of Damascus.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Mix it up. Yes. Mix it up.
Yeah. All the way.
Just
bowing, going to attend his business.
Mm-hmm. What you say?
Going to punish God's church.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Yeah. Not us.
On you.
Mm-hmm. What you say?
And some of these people today, I think it's my friend and brother here.
Mm-hmm.
But you
have to
be
careful. Yeah.
Yeah. How you deal with God's church.
Sure. Amen. Yes, sir.
All right.
Not only that, you know, but I say, you have to be careful, sure enough.
Yes. My Lord.
How you deal with God, anything that is God.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
But the people that are on the outside.
Yes. Well,
I know.
Go and fix it for you.
That are on the outer leg. Some of them are that are not converted unto God through Jesus Christ.
Well,
as we once were.
Yes, sir.
It is impossible, in a sense.
Mm-hmm.
For them to understand.
Well,
as we know and understand.
Yeah.
Except what they hear themselves,
yes,
unto God, and somehow, some way through this ministry.
Yes, sir.
Converted. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Paul was just that mean.
Yeah.
Well,
he was just that demon.
Mm-hmm.
At one time.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. He was just ignorant enough for all of his learning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Bad for you.
Let's discuss it and get to it.
Well, say it now. Yeah.
All of the knowledge he had.
Mm-hmm.
He's
good. Well.
Yeah.
Now
look. Yeah. Sometimes you think we know so much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You
may not
be like that.
All right. Well, fix it, preacher. Say it, preacher.
People can know so much,
we
can know so much sometimes and we don't know anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right,
sit. Admit how dumb, how ignorant we were.
Yeah. All right.
This is the way Paul was at that time.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Well prepared, man.
Uh-huh.
Lord help us today.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. Well prepared.
Yes,
well
sir.
Well able.
Yeah.
Yes.
To get himself straightened out.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh.
And you know, sometimes when we think we're so smart,
yeah,
he was looking the wrong way.
Yes, sir.
How do I use these words today?
Mm-hmm.
These three words, these three terms, it doesn't matter.
Matter.
Mm-hmm. But he was looking in the wrong direction.
Yes, sir.
Destroy.
Yes, sir.
Destroy, sir.
Yeah.
Trying to destroy that which brought him into being.
Matter. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Move it.
All right, preacher. All right.
Come on up, Doc.
Yeah. And when he had his encounter on with the master's word.
Yes, sir.
The Lord knocked him from the back of his beast.
Yes, sir.
Right. Into the.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
And this is a significant point to me.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it strange, regardless of how much we know, and how high we go? How lofty we put ourselves? God can bring us down.
In
the wrong direction, and he was too high.
Yes, sir.
preach out.
Looking in the right direction.
Yes, sir.
And we can also look in the proper direction. We must.
Yes.
Look unto God. What a joyous thing this is.
Yeah.
How much joy.
Yeah.
There is in serving God.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And what it means for one to be wrapped up.
Yes, sir.
Oh, come on and help me.
Tangled
up.
Yeah.
What did he say?
We don't have that now. All right.
Today I was converted.
Yeah.
Became a strong figure in the work of the Lord.
Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
And then we wrote this letter.
Yeah.
To some younger ministers.
Uh-huh.
At a seasonable age.
Go and fix it, preacher.
Have used up, have learned how.
Yeah.
To lead and to pin and to do the Lord's will.
That's up.
And drawn right.
Yeah.
In the service of our Lord.
Well,
that's why I was touched.
Uh-huh. Yes.
When one of the brethren mentioned.
Yes, sir.
The passing some years ago.
Uh-huh.
Of those who've gone before.
Yes,
sir. Who have suffered in this work.
Yeah.
Who have tried and who've striven and come to the point of going someplace else.
Yes, sir.
To me, that's wrong.
Yeah.
I couldn't help but be touched.
Well.
He had grown to a seasonable age and was right.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord had him to write these words.
Yeah. All right, preacher.
The young preachers don't know.
No, no.
Very young.
Yeah.
Talking about this is what I'm talking about.
Well.
You write this letter and tell the young minister what they must do.
Well.
Tell them and make it sometime or most time.
Yes, sir.
Pray with me. The good experiences.
Lord help.
Yeah. Well, I have a bad experience.
Yeah.
Of people older than we are.
Yes, sir.
It can be very helpful.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes, no matter how much trouble you're having.
Go on, preacher.
How many burdens you're sharing.
Well.
There's just somebody.
Yes, sir.
Around the corner.
Yeah.
Who has just a little bit more of them. What the test or what the case may be.
Yeah.
Somebody who has something they can tell you.
Well.
And the apostle Paul sat down and wrote it and said,
brother,
just like now.
Well.
In other words, he's just saying in general, I want you to know that some things I've come over.
Yes, sir.
In my life.
All right.
That I want to always forget. I don't want to remember some of the things.
Well,
that are in the past days of my life.
Yeah.
If we be fair with ourselves this afternoon.
Go on, why don't you say it now?
There are some things
in
all of our lives.
That
we don't want to bring up.
Yeah.
And things in everybody's life. You can call it whatever you want to.
Yes, sir.
You can call it skeletons in the closet. You can say your secret sins. But I'm living with it. Be sure. The secret sins will find you out. Then won't remember these things.
You
can forget them. This is what he was talking about, of how cruel he was to God's church. He didn't want all of the church. In generations to come and get the wrong impression.
Well,
he was so mean.
Yeah.
That he was so cruel and vicious. That he whipped and persecuted the saints of God. He didn't want this to be brought up. I'm forgetting these things. In the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Take your time and say it.
Don't forget
Some
of these things around us today.
We're
going to forget many names some of
them.
We're going to forget carrying certain privileges.
We're going to forget.
The praise is destroying.
We're
going to forget jealousy. We should out of our hands and take the Spirit of God. Forgetting all things in the past. And just take what you have. And if you're out, Jesus.
Yeah.
I Yes.
Thank you.